welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels. We have just a couple of announcements before we begin. First of all, to maintain a spirit of reverence and solemnity, there is to be no flash photography or videotaping during the ceremony. Please put away all cameras until the ceremony has concluded. Anyone taking pictures during the ceremony, other than the professional photographers, may be asked to leave. Be sure to turn off all mobile phone devices, and thank you for your cooperation.
Buenas tardes a todos. ¿Hay alguien que habla español por aquí? Sí, algunas personas. Bueno, para mantener un espíritu de reverencia, así como de solemnidad, no habrá tomas fotográficas ni videos durante la ceremonia. Favor de guardar sus cámaras hasta que la ceremonia haya concluido. Cualquier persona que esté tomando fotografías durante la ceremonia, que no sea los fotógrafos profesionales, se le pedirá que salga de la iglesia. Así es que, por favor, apaguen sus teléfonos celulares y cualquier otro aparato electrónico. Les agradecemos por su cooperación.
Today is our privilege to have leaders of other faith communities of Los Angeles joining us for this celebration. We welcome them warmly and appreciate their presence.
Es un privilegio para nosotros contar con la distinguida presencia de varios líderes de las comunidades ecuménicas de Los Ángeles. Les damos una cálida bienvenida y apreciamos su presencia en este evento. Muchas gracias.
Hello. We're about to begin our procession, and we ask that you please remain seated during the procession of the deacons. Thank you.
Vamos a comenzar ya la procesión. Les pedimos que por favor permanezcan en sus asientos durante la procesión de los diáconos. Gracias.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you. Welcome to you all to the Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels. This is a very special day for all of us here in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles as we gather for the ordination of a new bishop, Bishop-elect Alex Aclan. He's not a bishop yet. In a very special way, I would like to welcome the family of Bishop-elect Alex to this joyful celebration. Welcome to you all. I also especially want to welcome Archbishop Christopher Pierre, Apostolic Nuncio to the United States. Archbishop, welcome. As we know, he's the personal representative of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, in our country. So we especially ask God's blessings on him and his ministry, and also on Pope Francis and his ministry of guiding the church around the world. I will also welcome especially our Archbishop Emeritus, Colonel Roger Mahoney. And the Archbishop Emeritus of the Archdiocese of San Francisco, Colonel William Leveda. Welcome. I also want to welcome my brother bishops, my brother priests and deacons and their wives, and all of you again to this beautiful moment in the life and ministry of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. So let's, yeah. For the Lord Archdiocese. So let's start our celebration acknowledging our sins and preparing ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess
that you are the Lord, that I have been in my thoughts and words, in what I have done, what I have been here, through my heart, through my heart, and all my spirit is free. I express the prayer of the Lord's prayer, all the angels and saints, and you, my successors,
may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison.
us pray. O God, eternal shepherd, who govern your flock with watchful care, choose to join Alex, your servant and priest, to the College of Bishops this day. Grant, we pray, that by his holiness of life, he may everywhere prove to be a true witness to Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Ang simula ng aklat ni Propeta Jeremias. Sinabi sa akin ng Panginoon, pinili na kita bago ka ipinaglihi upang maging propeta sa lahat ng bansa. Sinabi ko naman, Panginoon, hindi po ako marunong magsalita. Bata pa po ako. Subalit sinabi niya sa akin, huwag mong sabihin bata ka. Sinusugo kita, kaya't humayo ka. Ipahayag mo sa lahat ang aking iuutos sa iyo. Huwag mo silang katatakutan, pagkat ako'y sa iyo at iingatan kita. Akong Panginoon ang nagsasabi nito. Pagkatapos, iniunat ng Panginoon ang kanyang bisig. Hinipo ang mga labi ko at sinabi, Hayan, ibinibigay ko sa iyo ang dapat mong sabihin. Ibinibigay ko rin ngayon sa iyo ang kapangyarihan sa mga bansa't mga kaharian. Sila'y bunutin at ibagsak, lipulin at iwasak, ibangon at itatag. Ang salita ng Diyos.
Blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ the Lord. El cáliz que bendecimos es la comunión de la sangre de Cristo. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ. El cáliz que bendecimos es la comunión de la sangre de Cristo. How can I repay the Lord the goodness God has shown to me? The cup of blessing I raise, I call upon God's name. Our blessing cup is a communion with the blood of Christ the Lord. El cáliz que bendecimos es la comunión de la sangre. Es la muerte de sus fieles. Soy tu sirviente, tu hijo. God, and call upon your name, Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord. In the presence of God's people,
de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los filipenses. Hermanos, yo, Pablo, prisionero por la causa del Señor, los exhorto a que lleven una vida digna del llamamiento que han recibido. Sean siempre humildes y amables. Sean comprensivos. Sopórtense mutuamente con amor. Esfuércense en mantenerse unidos en el espíritu con el vínculo de la paz. Porque no hay más que un solo cuerpo y un solo espíritu, como es también solo una la esperanza del llamamiento que ustedes han recibido. Un solo Señor, una sola fe, un solo bautismo, un solo Dios y Padre de todos, que reina sobre todos, actúa a través de todos y vive en todos. Cada uno de nosotros ha recibido la gracia en la medida en que Cristo se la ha dado. Él fue quien concedió a unos ser apóstoles, a otros ser profetas, a otros ser evangelizadores, a otros ser pastores y maestros, y esto para capacitar a sus fieles, a fin de que desempeñando debidamente su tarea, construyan el cuerpo de Cristo, hasta que todos lleguemos a estar unidos en la fe y en el conocimiento del Hijo de Dios, y lleguemos a ser hombres perfectos, que alcancemos en todas sus dimensiones la plenitud de Cristo. Palabra de Dios.
Thank you. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
El Espíritu del Señor está sobre mí. Me ha enviado para anunciar la buena nueva a los pobres.
Aleluya, 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 aleluya.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to Jesus summoned his disciples and said to them, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and the great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just so the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Please remain standing.
Thank you. Most Reverend Father, the Holy Catholic Church, our Mother, asks you to ordain this priest, Monsignor Alex Aclan, to the office of bishop.
Have you a mandate from the Holy See?
We have.
Let it be read.
Your Eminence, Cardinal Mahoney, Your Eminence Cardinal Levada, Your Excellency Archbishop Gomez, Your Excellency Bishop Oscar Solis, another Filipino bishop, Your Excellency, Your Excellency Auxiliary Bishop-elect Aclan, my brother archbishops and bishops, dear priests, deacons, consecrated religious and lay faithful of the Church in Los Angeles, dear friends, it gives me great joy to be with you today in this beautiful Cathedral of Our Lady of the Angels as Monsignor Alejandro Alex Aclan, a native of the Philippines, is ordained to the fullness of the priesthood and begins his episcopal ministry as auxiliary bishop of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, serving alongside his brother auxiliaries to assist Archbishop Gomez in the pastoral care of the largest Archdiocese in the United States. Monsignor Aclan, I know that you wanted a nice, quiet sabbatical. But the Holy Father has called you to something great in the service of the Church. Having grown up in the Philippines, you know about change. Changing countries, changing professions from medical technology to electronic data processing to managing projects at a bank. Now, the Lord is calling you to help Archbishop Gomez serve the local church of Los Angeles. Service is also something you know about. Having had the loving example of your parents, your father is revered as a hero in the Philippines, knowing his share of suffering and yet courageously making sacrifices in the name of freedom. Now God is calling you to something heroic, to preach his gospel and to lift the burdens of his people. These days, everyone wants to see the Avengers movie. I suppose we could speculate about your superhero name, but there can be no question about your superpower, the power of prayer. May God be your strength as you begin this new mission in the service of the Church. And now it is my pleasure to read for you the translation of the Apostolic Letter of Appointment. This letter will be shown to you by Bishop Alex later. This is a letter signed by Pope Francis. Francis, Bishop, servants of the servants of God. To our beloved son, Alejandro Dombridge Aclan, from the clergy of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, appointed auxiliary bishop of the same see, and likewise promoted to the titular church of Rusicade. Greetings and apostolic blessing. Having divested ourselves of the old, let us clothe ourselves with the new man, not only by reason of the new commandment, which truly renews those who listen to it, but also on account of that love which the Lord distinguishes from carnal affection, so that, as a result, we are new men, heirs of the New Testament, making and gathering together a new people, whose desire then will be satisfied when God will be all in all. Supported by this hope, which is the foundation of the imitation of the merciful love of Christ and of our very own pastoral activity, as we diligently spare no pains to provide for the spiritual welfare of Christ's faithful and the fruitful governance of the Church, it is with paternal affection that we direct our thoughts to caring for the pastoral good of the flock of Los Angeles, whose ordinary or venerable brother, José Horacio Gomez, not very long ago requested helpful assistance for carrying out his ministry to the Archdiocese. For this reason, beloved son, our thoughts turn to you, who, in the exercise of your various responsibilities in this Archdiocese, have shown yourself up to now to be well equipped with the experience as well as the human and priestly qualities, rendering you, in our judgment, one who is suitable for undertaking this office. Therefore, upon consultation with the Congregation for Bishops, by our apostolic authority, we appoint you auxiliary bishop of the ecclesial community of Los Angeles, at the same time elevating you to the titular church of Rusicade, conferring upon you all the due rights and imposing the obligations which are connected to this office. You may receive episcopal ordination from any Catholic bishop outside the city of Rome, the liturgical norms being observed. Prior to this, however, you must make the profession of faith and take the oath of fidelity toward us and our successors in accord with the norms of ecclesiastical law. Finally, beloved son, it is our earnest plea that you pastor the flock in fraternal harmony and unity with the chief shepherd of this church, and that you be a servant of your neighbor, a servant who is not greater than his master, and that you welcome the poor as Christ himself. Given at Rome, at St. Peter's, on the fifth day of the month of March, in the year of the Lord 2019, the sixth of our pontificate. And it is signed Pope Francis.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I think you should have gone all the way to the back. You see? That's where the real fans are, in the back. What a beautiful moment in the life of our church, the family of God here in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. We thank God today, and we thank our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for this new bishop, our brother, Monsignor Alex Aclan. The words of the prophet ring in our ears today. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. I consecrated you. I appointed you. You are called. We are called. God has a passionate love, and God has a plan for his creation. There is no one here today, not one of us, who does not have a special purpose in God's providence. So, my brother Alex, God has called you in this time and place, in this moment, in the church. Today, he consecrates you and appoints you to be a bishop in a time of renewal and reform in the church. It is a time, as we know, with shadows and uncertainty, but it is also a time of bright hope and new possibilities. My brothers and sisters, Jesus is still building his church, still building the beautiful city of God on the rock of St. Peter and the 12 foundations of the apostles. And we are witnesses to that today in this Episcopal ordination. Today, a living stone is being built upon this great foundation. Christ Jesus is calling to himself a new successor of the apostles. He's building up his body, as St. Paul tells us in the second reading. My brother, Jesus reminds you today in the gospel that as a bishop, you are not a lord, but a servant. You are not a master, but a father. As a bishop, you need to let Jesus to be your only teacher. Be with him to adore him and gaze on him in the Eucharist. Talk to him. Make time every day to study his words and his actions in the gospel. St. Thomas Aquinas used to say, every action of Christ serves as instruction for us. And this is especially true for a bishop. My brother, I pray that you will turn every day ever deeper into the heart of Jesus, so that his heart beats in yours, so that you live your life as he did, not for yourself, but for others, for the glory of God and the salvation of your brothers and sisters. And you must use the power that Jesus gives you as Jesus used his own power, in humility and loving service. The Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. He speaks those words to you today, my dear brother. And today he sends you out, just as he sent out his first apostles. He sends you to continue his mission, to make this world his kingdom, to call our brothers and sisters to walk in his footsteps. And Jesus goes with you on this mission. His Spirit is still speaking to the church. And we have his promise. The gates of hell, the power of death, will never prevail against us. This time in the church, this time of renewal, is a call for every one of us to return to Jesus. It is a call to continue the conversion of our hearts. At another time of reforming the church, St. Charles Borromeo told his bishops, "This is indeed the task, to seek the things which are of God, not our own. This is the ministry of the pastor. This is still the task, still the ministry of the pastor. The church does not belong to any of us. The church belongs to God, and his plan is still in play. We need to seek the things of God, his will, not our will. Christ can renew us. Christ will renew us. We only need to open our hearts to his mercy. And only when we have opened our hearts to him can we open our mouths to proclaim him." So let us remember the words of the prophet we heard today. "To whomever I send you, go. Whatever I command you, speak. And do not be afraid, for I am with you to deliver you." And God speaks these words today in a special word to you, Bishop-elect Alex. But he also speaks these words to all of us, my dear brothers and sisters, to everyone in the church at this moment in time. Let us bring Jesus into this world, wherever he sends us, and let us speak his words of hope and love, and let us take courage and know that God goes with us. And may your blessed Mother Mary watch over you, my dear brother, as you start your new ministry among us. And may she be the mother to all of us, leading us to her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Beloved, consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church in which our brother is about to be raised. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who was sent by the Father to redeem the human race, in turn sent 12 apostles into the world. They were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit to preach the gospel and to sanctify and govern all the peoples gathered into one flock. Moreover, that this office might remain to the end of time, the apostles chose helpers for themselves. Through the laying on of hands, by which the fullness of the sacrament of holy orders is conferred, they handed out to them the gift of the Holy Spirit, which they had received from Christ. In that way, the tradition handed down from the beginning through the unbroken succession of bishops is preserved from generation to generation, and the work of the Savior continues on and grows even to our own times. In the bishop, surrounded by his priest, our Lord Jesus Christ himself, having become high priest forever, is present among us. For through the ministry of the bishop, Christ himself never fails to proclaim the gospel and to administer the sacraments of faith to those who believe. Through the bishop's exercise of his duty as father, Christ himself adds new members to his body. To the bishop's wisdom and prudence, it is Christ himself who leads you in your earthly pilgrimage toward eternal happiness. Gladly and gratefully, therefore, welcome our brother whom we, the bishops, now admit into our college by the laying on of hands. Revere him as a minister of Christ and a steward of the mysteries of God. He has been entrusted with the task of bearing witness to the truth of the gospel and with the ministry of the Spirit and of justice. Remember the words Christ spoke to the apostles. "Whoever listens to you, listens to me. And whoever rejects you, rejects me. And whoever rejects me rejects the one who sent me. And now, dear brother, who has been chosen by the Lord, consider that you are chosen from among men and appointed on their behalf for those things that pertain to God. The title of bishop is one of service, not of honor. And therefore, a bishop should strive to benefit others rather than lord it over them. Such is the precept of the master. The greater should behave as the least and the ruler as the servant. Preach the word in season and out of season. Reprove with all patience and sound teaching. As you pray and offer sacrifice for the people committed to your care, devote yourself wholeheartedly to seeking every kind of grace for them from the fullness of Christ's holiness. In the church entrusted to you, be a faithful steward, moderator, and guardian of the mysteries of Christ. Since you are chosen by the Father to rule over his family, be mindful always of the Good Shepherd, who knows his sheep and is known by them, and who did not hesitate to lay down his life for them. With the charity of a father and brother, love all whom God places in your care, especially the priests and deacons, who are your co-workers in the ministry of Christ, but also the poor and the weak, immigrants and strangers. Exhort the faithful to work with you in your apostolic labor. Do not refuse to listen willingly to them. Never relax your concerns for those who are not yet gathered into the one fold of Christ. They too are entrusted to you in the Lord. Never forget that you are joined to the College of Bishops in the Catholic Church, made one by the bond of charity, and therefore you should have a constant concern for all the churches and gladly come to the support of churches in need. And so, keep watch over the whole flock, in which the Holy Spirit appoints you to govern the Church of God. In the name of the Father, on whose image you represent in the Church, and in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, whose office of teacher, priest, and shepherd you will discharge, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the Church of Christ, and by his power strengthen us in our weakness. The ancient rule of the fathers ordains that the bishop elect is to be questioned in the presence of the people on his resolve to uphold the faith and to discharge his duty. And so, dear brother, do you resolve by the grace of the Holy Spirit to discharge until death the office entrusted to us by the apostles, which were about to pass on to you by the laying on of our hands?
I do.
Do you resolve to preach the gospel of Christ with constancy and fidelity?
I do.
Do you resolve to guard the deposit of faith entire and incorrupt, as handed down by the apostles and preserving the church everywhere and at all times?
I do.
Do you resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in the unity of that body together with the order of bishops under the authority of the successor of St. Peter the Apostle?
I do.
Do you resolve to render obedience faithfully to the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
Do you resolve to guide the holy people of God in the way of salvation as a devoted father and sustain them with the help of your fellow ministers, the priests and deacons?
I do.
Do you resolve for the sake of the Lord's name to be welcoming and merciful to the poor, to strangers, and to all who are in need?
I do.
Do you resolve as a good shepherd to seek out the sheep who stray and gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
Finally, do you resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for the holy people and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Please stand.
Dearly beloved, let us pray that the kindness of Almighty God, in providing for the welfare of the Church, will grant an abundance of His grace for this chosen one.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Holy Mary, Mother of God.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Michael.
Ora pro nobis.
Holy angels of God.
Ora te pro nobis.
Saint John the Baptist.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Joseph.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Peter.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Paul.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Andrew.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint James.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Thomas.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint James.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Philip.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Bartholomew.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Matthew.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Simon.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Jude.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Matthias.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Mary Magdalene.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Stephen.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Lawrence.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity.
Ora te pro nobis.
Saint Agnes.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Gregory.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Augustine.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Athanasius.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Basil.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Martin.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic.
Ora te pro nobis.
Saint Francis Xavier.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John Vianney.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Catherine of Siena.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Teresa of Jesus.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Finbar.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John of God.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Magdalene Sophie.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John Bosco.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Anthony.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Padre Pio.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Teresa of Calcutta.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John Paul II.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint John the 23rd.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Paul the 4th.
Ora pro nobis.
Saint Patrick.
ora pro nobis.
Saint Emidia,
ora pro nobis.
Saint Viviana,
ora pro nobis.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
ora te pro nobis.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your incarnation.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by your death and resurrection.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
be merciful to us sinners.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Govern and protect your holy church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all the ordained in faithful service to your church.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless this chosen man.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless and sanctify this chosen man.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bless, sanctify, and consecrate this chosen man.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring all peoples together in peace and true harmony.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Comfort with your mercy the troubled and the afflicted.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Strengthen all of us and keep us in your holy service.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, and pour out upon this, your servant, the power of your blessing, flowing from the horn of priestly grace, through Christ our Lord. Thank you. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high and look upon the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, and who lay down observances in your church through the word of your grace, who from the beginning foreordained a nation of the just, born of Abraham, who established rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministers, and who from the foundation of the world were pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Pour out now upon this chosen one that power which is from you, the governing spirit, whom you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the spirit whom he bestowed upon the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as your sanctuary for the glory and unceasing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that this, your servant, whom you have chosen for the office of bishop, may shepherd your holy flock, serving you night and day. May he fulfill before you without reproach the ministry of the high priesthood, that always gaining your favor, he may offer up the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of the high priesthood, he may have the power to forgive sins according to your command, assign offices according to your decree, and loose every bond according to the power given by you to the apostles. May he please you by his meekness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours, with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, now and forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
May God, who has made you a sharer of the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings.
Yes.
receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith, preserved unblemished, the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre, and may the splendor of holiness shine forth in you. So that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crosier, the sign of your pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
Please be seated.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, O Lord, which we have presented for your church and for Alex, your servant and bishop, become an offering acceptable to you and for the good of the flock. May he whom you have raised upon among your people to be high priest be endowed by your gift with apostolic virtues. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just
our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, our Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design, were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with the royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the Paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exultation we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, my assistant bishops, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosman and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that to your whole family, which we make to you, also for your servant Alex, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of bishops, and in your mercy, keep safe your gifts in him, so that what he has received by divine commission, he may fulfill by divine assistance. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that he may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread, his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven, O Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings, a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body of Christ give me safe for eternal life.
Lord, our God is good.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, O Lord, increase the gifts of your grace in Alex, your servant and bishop, that he may serve you worthily in the pastoral ministry and receive the eternal rewards of a faithful steward. Through Christ our Lord.
Oh,
Please be seated. Well, this is really more overwhelming than I thought. And I just want to express my gratitude to all of you who have joined us in this celebration this afternoon. We know that you know our liturgies, especially our Eucharist, is a foretaste of heaven on earth. And I cannot think of a better foretaste of heaven than this celebration right now. Everybody is here. Including people that I knew when I was a teenager that I haven't seen in years. I am not kidding. I am absolutely surprised that they are here. But I would like, first of all, to thank Pope Francis and Archbishop Pierre and Archbishop Jose Gomez for deeming me well-suited, as the Archbishop said in his homily, to take on this new ministry, or not the homily, but I mean what Archbishop Pierre read, for deeming me ready to take on this new ministry as Auxiliary Bishop of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. And I want to thank my mother and my father, who are both now in heaven, and my brothers and sisters who are right here in this first pew right in front of me. For creating a home where I saw lived out in its fullness the virtues of faith, hope, and love manifested in hospitality, generous sharing, care, compassion, forgiveness, and joyfulness. I would like to thank all the priests and religious sisters who have inspired me and prayed for me at some point in my life. Special thanks to all of the priests who are in ministry in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, whom I had the privilege of serving when I was the vicar for clergy. Many of these priests are veritable saints and heroes who deserve our respect and reverence. I would like to thank all the lovely children, women, and men faithful who have made my priestly ministry so fulfilling and satisfying all these years. The 25 years, I celebrated my 25 years as a priest last July. And I would like to thank these children, these women and men faithful, for all their prayers for me during my years of ministry. I would like to say a special thank you to the parish and office staff who have helped me in all of the parishes where I have been assigned. I've had a few parish and office housekeepers. You know, they were the ones who made sure that the refrigerators are stocked so that I would eat properly. You know, the handymen and custodians who would make sure that I don't climb steps to change a light bulb that's out. And also all those individuals who have enabled me to do my ministry effectively because of their support. And I would like to thank in a very special way our Blessed Mother, the Blessed Virgin, who has never left me unaided in all of my years since childhood. And of course, I would like to thank, in the most special way of all, our God, the Father, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. who, as Psalm 139 says, knew me from the moment I was knit in my mother's womb, and who has decreed every one of my days. I would like to thank him for bringing me to this moment that is causing so much joy to everyone I've come in contact with in my life, and many others whom I have yet to meet. And so to God, let us all give glory and praise.
Just one brief announcement before the final blessing. For those who would like to congratulate Bishop Alex or to receive his blessing after the celebration of the liturgy here in the cathedral, I would invite you to make your way to the north colonnade, which is here to my right. If you would just start forming a line and go to the very end of the colonnade, you'll make a right. And if you would then patiently wait, and as soon as Bishop Alex is available, he will come out to greet you, and also if you would like to receive his blessing. Thank you.
Please stand for the final blessing. I ask Bishop Alex to come with me right here, that you can help me to give the blessing. You already gave a lot of blessings, but again, I want to thank all of you for coming today. I think it is, as I said at the beginning, a great day of joy for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles and for Bishop Alex and his family. I also want to thank the seminarians for being here. Thank you for being here. And our choir, Joy Basuros, the director. Let's keep praying for Bishop Alex and for all the bishops and the priests. We need your prayers. So and give thanks to God for especially through the ministry of Pope Francis that has given us a new bishop. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May the Lord bless you and keep you, and as he has willed to set you as high priest over his people, so he make you happy in this present life and grant you a share in the happiness that is eternal.
Amen.
May he grant that the clergy and people he has chosen to unite by his gracious help be happily governed by his providence and your stewardship for many years to come.
Amen.
And may they obey God's commandments freed from adversity, and they may abound in all that is good, submitting in faith to your ministry, so they may enjoy peace and tranquility in the present age, and will you be found worthy to share the company of the citizens of eternity.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace and announce the gospel of the Lord.
And I'll stay.